Welcome back. Satisfactory. I'm so glad you're here. Alright, so I just picked up all the stuff. Just picked it all up. And I think we're just gonna build out the crystal oscillator part of this factory from the comfort. Maybe we're too far up. Yeah, we're too far away. From the comfort of our computer complex. And thought is that if we come over here and put this on the corner, a 2x2, we can use this 3x4 recipe, or I'm sorry, blueprint, to get the crystal oscillator section of this done. Let's build 2 as is our standard here, and go back and do a quick double check to make sure everything is generally about what we expected. So that's going to connect to here. Like that. Our inputs are going to be way over here, which is okay. Blueprint mode is probably the best thing ever. All right, so thing is that this part of the factory is going to be more vertical. We've only allowed it 9 spaces. We just used them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So from here on out, we've got to go vertical if we want to finish the rest of these 12 machines. Oh, I finally ran out of material. One moment. Okay. I think that's a good chunk of everything. I can grab an extra little bit of encased beam so we can make belts while we're at it. Actually get to hover after all. I'm wondering if there's a... No. There's not. Three more of those. Getting kind of tall at this point. But there you go. We got it done. Now, let's see where we actually landed in a place without any obstruction down below, so that's great. Not to do anything wacky or weird to get the materials up here or out. I think what I should do first is maybe try to figure out the power situation. Easy way to do it would be to just connect from over here. Let's see, what did I do over here? We already connected the power through this, which means we probably have a little connection going through here. But let's make sure we're not dealing with the light side of our power. You know what? I didn't set aside any materials for our light switch. Need a couple AIs. AI limiters, to be precise. And let's just put some light controls down, if you'll be so kind. Okay, so with that, it should be pretty simple just to connect horizontally. I should connect our first two levels, which is effectively one copy of the blueprint. Oh. That color's already set. It's probably because... Oh. We're limited to this number of colors. Ooh, that could be bad news. Okay, so now we know we want three of these. Uh-oh, did I calculate three or two? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 9, 10. We might have to steal another square out here to feed all this. And just for spacing and calculating, you build the first three when the second three are really the three that we want. Copy that. Lift it up. Yeah, we're gonna need a lot of these. So we're gonna have to, like, if this is gonna have any chance, we're gonna have to dance it all the way back here. But chances are good that we're gonna need two rows of this. So we're gonna have to step out probably one extra like this to then get things going. But first, let's get all the resources set up, which is why I have Crystal Oscillator on my to-do list using my alternative recipe. Requires rubber, which is good news because our factory down here, and I way overbuilt this. This is what happens when the trains drop everything off. It gets lifted up to this sorting level. And a lot of the area then gets... Each train car basically gets its own storage and awesome sink, which is overkill. Uh-oh. Let's go over here and steal some pipe. Maybe not all of it. thinking about, do we want more awesome sinks, believe it or not? I think the answer is generally yes. But we'll just leave room for one. And let's see, where is this gonna land? Uh-oh, right in the middle of this other belt. We're gonna have to make a little side quest for it. Or we'll have to drop a couple of these down to get it. Let's do that. Just making sure we're not interrupting anybody else. Sometimes I wish I could reverse these after they're built, but I'm sure there's a technical efficiency reason where it would run the game slower if you could make that determination. At least that's what I tell myself. So there's our first three uploads. I don't know. Was gonna come to the floor, but that's gonna make it almost impossible to move around. Eventually. It's actually gonna be a little bit more difficult than I planned. Unless I put on a merger. I'm not sure why that'll help me though. Let's just start these two off. Easy to. Not gonna be perfect, but we're gonna try to get as close as we can. Sometimes you just wonder how those types of super crazy extended weird links happen. I know, I'm trying to get this perfectly lined up vertically. It looks good horizontally. That's it. Now this is too close together. There we go. Okay, there you go. First level connected with rubber. Let's go connect some additional levels. What do you think? A quartz crystal? Yeah. Normally I might suggest that we just pack all this together, but we are gonna need some leeway. Make sure all this other stuff gets in there. Need some concrete. Also grabbing some other stuff. Ow. All right, quartz crystal. We can grab these two to start. That's probably too close. That's still probably too close. If we come out manually, though, we could probably make it happen. Which direction is this in? Probably the wrong one. Was right the whole time. is so weird that sometimes when you click on these, it'll say, yeah, it'll work. And then when you go to actually confirm it, it totally, completely whiffs you. I already know this is too close, but if you don't try, that's a classic example. I click on it, I drag it around, it says, yes, this will work. Then you click on it, and it says, oh no, no, it won't work. So bad. Whoa, boy. Forgot I wasn't on the jetpack. I guess the jetpack or the hovercraft and... I don't even know what this thing is called. What's it called again? The zipline horse. Kind of overkill. Alright, so we put in... 4 lines worth of... high-end quartz quality crystals, or quality quartz crystals, one of the two. I have to do this 5 more times. Yikes. What we'll do is we'll just go as far as we can at the highest level. Then when we get into the zone, we'll drop down. I should connect this one on the inner loop right here. All right. Got some quartz crystal coming in. I think you might be able to just magically link in some AI goodness. I think this recipe actually calls for very low number of AI. Yeah, 1 total. So 15 times is only like, say it's 2 per minute per machine. 1 machine worth would only be 2 per minute. So 32 machine worth is only 60 per minute. So we could get away with a pretty aggressive splitter at this point. Something like, you just need to get it in the area. Oh, see, I'm glad I checked. connect a splitter directly to this lift. We'll loop that in there and loop that in there. We know we have AI down here somewhere. Where did we store that AI? Over here, I think it was. Here it is. Let's see, it comes in and it goes down to the bottom floor. Playing air traffic controller here to get this goodness over here. Hey, there we go. I do believe I hear this spinning up. Yeah, see, it doesn't. Compared to the others, it really doesn't take that many AI limiters, so we're good. I'm gonna cut this here. I'm gonna make this a two-parter. And the reason is because I wanna take some time to really think through how we're gonna get material up and down these levels. This is a lot of levels. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 levels. So that's 10 items down, which isn't great, but isn't terrible comparative. But 30 items up, and that's gonna be tough. I don't know that there's room for 30 of these. There was most certainly not room for 30 of them right here. We'd have to stop, like, at that point. Yeah. 13. We're gonna have to make like a little end cap here. Like this. At the very least. And then we would make one. Six, seven, nine. Look at that. It's not even enough to capture all the output. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Maybe I'll pull the first two down in a single or something. I don't know. We'll have to figure it out. But like I said, I want to have time to really do it right, make it look classy. Luckily, we're on a pretty extensive service layer. So all of this is looking pretty good up here. Yeah, we're gonna call that in part one. We got our first two levels connected, and now we're gonna have a compacted vertical storage solution. And I wanna have some time to really think about a really good solution. So let's call it. We're gonna say thanks for hanging out. I really do appreciate it. And we'll see you next time.